right, everybody, here we are. We're at the Catalyst Games Labs booth, and we just finished a game of DragonFire. All right, so I'm going to try to give you guys a quick rundown on exactly how this worked. It was really fun, guys. All right, so we start with a deck of cards, well, a hand of cards, all right? We actually start with a character. Now, in a typical game, these are the types of cards that you would have, all right? But for the demo, we kind of had a Mod Podge group of cards in our hands. The main thing you're going to be looking at is these little symbols up here in the upper left-hand corner. Now, some of them could have abilities down here at the bottom of the card as well, where you can help and assist the other players around the board. It is a full cooperative game. Now, what you're going to be doing, though, is that you're going to have monsters that are going to be placed in front of you and each one of the other people that are a part of your party as well. To be able to defeat these monsters, you basically just have to match the symbols, or if it's a gray area on the card, you have to just discard that many cards. So this guy here is like one of the biggest, hardest monsters in the game. He's like a roper. His is the payout, which is gold. He does have a surprise ability. Not necessary for me to explain that to you. I'm just going to explain to you how you kill the monster, okay? So right here at the very top, it shows you that it requires four cards to be discarded to be able to move down a level on the side of his card. If you notice right there, see the four? Then after that, you would have to play a blue card out of your hand, then two generics of any, then a, like, warrior type of card, then another blue, which would represent magic, and then three of just any type. Now, as he is being leveled down, you just keep moving this marker. So if I wanted to, I could take all four of these cards, discard them. Okay, I discarded those. He's now down to the magic portion. Now, here's where it's kind of cool. The other players around the table can try to help and assist you to defeat this monster. So they could play cards out of their hands that possibly say assist at the bottom. So, for instance, right here, see down at the bottom, it says assist, deal one level of damage. This is a specific level right here. So if that was the case, if I had that card, I could play it to be able to assist him to immediately move this marker down one full level and, you know, bypass any of the symbols or the amounts of cards that were listed on that. The other thing, too, is that once the creature is 100% defeated, everybody then gets to share in the gold. Just because I defeated it doesn't mean that I get to hoard the gold. No, because then that makes one player a little bit too powerful compared to the other ones, right? This is a cooperative. So this guy would then, once he is finished, you keep going down, 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 down. He is dead. Boom, everybody gets 10 gold. So on your turn, you would play, you would hit the monster, hopefully kill it, then you take any gold that you have and you get to go up here into the market and you get to buy cards. As soon as you buy a card, it would go immediately into your hand and would be available to you to help, hopefully assist the other players around the table and also be used to, for, you know, for useful for you for the very next turn as well. If you don't defeat the creature, you're going to take damage that's listed down here at the bottom of it. In this case, I would have taken 2 damage, boom, boom, and I go down. Eventually, I become stunned, eventually I become unconscious. At the beginning of each round, these monsters are going to spawn out. If we don't defeat all of them, then more monsters spawn out. And then eventually, hopefully, we could try to defeat all of them to where we could go into a rest period. But unfortunately, because this is a demo, we did not get a chance to understand what a rest actually meant, all right? But the purpose of this is that given the fact that I'm a wizard, he is a cleric, she was a rogue, and she was a fighter, you want to try to draft cards into your deck that are going to cater to your character's abilities. Some of them, in fact, require you to be of a certain class to be able to play them. And you always just match it based upon color. I'm a wizard. I'm blue. Easy. I know what kind of cards to look for. He's a cleric. He's green. He knows what kinds of cards to look for as well. We only played a couple of rounds. That's about all the gist that I got out of this game. But I can't tell you just straight up, this was a lot of fun to play. I am really shocked at the simplicity of it. But on top of that, just how much fun it was to try to talk with the other players around the table and try to organize how exactly we were going to draft our cards into our hands to try to defeat all the creatures around the board. And of course, I am as well joined by Tim Bresnan from Dad vs. Daughter. Hello. Hey, what were your thoughts on this one?
It's a good game. Of course, you know, Dad and Daughter like cooperative deck building games. This kind of hits all the marks, so two thumbs up.
Awesome, awesome. You did an awesome demo. Thank you very much. K-Man, what did you think of this one, brother?
I loved it. I loved the co-op. It's much easier than Shadowrun Crossfire.
Uh-huh.
Flowed really well.
Awesome. Well, guys, check out this one, DragonFire from Catalyst Game Labs. I'm telling you guys, this one is a good one. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.